Kia ora koutou, he kamahi au, konihara, tai o ki Waitaha, ko Matt Tokoinga. So I work for Environment Canterbury. My name is Matt and I'm a youth engagement advisor for the Regional Council. So I've been brought along today to support the Tamariki with a bug hunt as they start to restore this area, to turn, kind of take a bit of a baseline as to what invertebrates call this place home before the forest starts to become established. I think for me the most important thing about these collaborative projects are that it connects young people to their local environment, so they have an appreciation of what they share this wonderful place with, and they act instinctively in ways to protect it. If you show them a small creature or a taonga species like a long-finned eel or something like that, then they care about their waterways and they care about their rako and the trees that live near them. So the great thing about these collaborative projects between Te Nako and Te Ara Kakariki and ourselves at Environment Canterbury is that we can't, because it pulls on everyone's strengths. And it's really, really nice to see that the collaboration between Te Nako and Te Ara Kakariki is thriving, and it's helping communities where people live and where the projects are based. It's great. So no, it couldn't happen without everyone getting involved. So the day, the Kids Discovery Plant Out days are bespoke for each school. So Lou, the Te Ara Kakariki coordinator, will work alongside the teachers to craft a day that suits their curriculum and their inquiry focus. So today the kids are taking a bit of a baseline. They're learning about the invertebrates that live here, but they're also learning about the cultural values of the plants through weaving with Aunty Daphne from Ngāti Mōki Marae, using some locally sourced harakiki or flax. I know that the Te Ara Kakariki Green Dot is to create a pathway of green dots, like little bellbird supermarkets from Ka Tiritiri o Te Moana, the mountains, to Te Wahora, Lake Ellesmere. So that vision too, for me, means people enjoying those birds that have come back into these environments. The Selwyn Plains have got less than 0.5% native vegetation on, so that ultimately that vision is to get this ecosystem back to a functioning ecosystem.